بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، we are continuing in our discussion of the names of Allah Azza wa Jal. And today we will discuss perhaps the third or the second most common name of Allah Azza wa Jal, of the top five names of Allah Azza wa Jal. We mentioned, of course, the most common name, which is Allah. And then we mentioned other common names, Ar-Rahim and Al-Ghafoor and Al-Ghaffar. Of the top five names of Allah in terms of sheer quantity in the Quran is the name of Allah Al-Aziz. The name of Allah Al-Aziz. And this name, it occurs a staggering 92 times, almost 100 times as a proper noun. And of course, it also occurs as verbs and adjectives. And Allah Azza wa Jal calls Himself Rabbul Izzah, the Lord of Izzah. So there's the proper noun Al-Aziz, and there's adjectives, and there's so many other descriptions. What exactly does Al-Aziz mean? The word Aziz, obviously, is the proper noun from Azza. And Azza actually means to be powerful. It means to have protection, to have might. So the primary connotation of Azza is to be powerful and mighty. And that is why a person who is Aziz, such as in Surah Yusuf, when Allah mentions that it was the wife of Aziz. A person who is Aziz is a person of power, a person of might. So the minister in Surah Yusuf is called Aziz as a title. That wasn't his name, the title. It was the person of power. As well, in Surah Yasin, we see the verb, what it really means, that Allah says in the Quran, that we sent two people to them, they rejected both. So then, فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِثِ, we strengthened them with a third. So, عَزَّزَ, to strengthen. We strengthened them with a third. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah Maryam, وَاتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ آلِهَةً لِيَكُونُ لَهُمْ عِزَّا. And they think that there should be gods besides Allah, so that they seek protection and power from those gods. لِيَكُونُ مِن دُونِهِ عِزَّا. They're trying to find عِزَّا from other than Al-Aziz. And so the meaning of Al-Aziz, when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has a number of connotations. Number one, Al-Aziz means the powerful. So in this sense, it is synonymous with Al-Qawi. So in one sense, Al-Aziz is synonymous with the powerful, Al-Qawi. Number two, Al-Aziz also means that no one can harm Allah and no one can escape from His power and dominion. So Al-Aziz, the one whose power envelopes everything, and no one has the power to be outside of the Izzah of Al-Aziz. No one has the power to act outside of the power of the one who has power. Number three, Al-Aziz is the one whom you must seek protection from, and no one can protect you against him. So Al-Aziz, the one who gives you protection, and no one can protect you against him. And this is explicitly mentioned in the Quran, وَهُوَ يُجِيرُ وَلَا يُجَارُ عَلَيْهِ. Allah is saying in the Quran, ask them, قُلْ مَا رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ السَّبْعِ. Who is the Rabb of the heavens and earth? Who is the one who is the Lord of the great throne? Who is the one who is يُجِيرُ وَلَا يُجَارُ عَلَيْهِ. You have to turn to protect yourself against enemies, and you can turn to no one to protect yourself against him. وَهُوَ يُجِيرُ وَلَا يُجَارُ عَلَيْهِ. He's the one who protects, and there's nothing that can protect you against him. So this is also of the meanings of Al-Aziz, and of the meanings of Al-Aziz in the name, in the case of Allah Azza wa Jal, Al-Aziz is the one who has honor, which is Izzah. So Izzah also means honor, because the one who has power also has honor. The one who has might also has honor. You cannot be a person of great honor in a political sense, except that you have some type of power. So Izzah also means power. And so Al-Aziz, the one who has that honor, Sahibul Izzah, the one who has ultimate honor, and honor of power, and honor of rank, and honor of protection. So the name of Allah Al-Aziz, it should give Muslims, all of us who believe in Al-Aziz, a sense of honor ourselves. It should give us a sense of security. If we believe in Al-Aziz, then who can harm us? If Al-Aziz gives his Izzah to us, who can possibly take it away? And that's why Allah says, قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ. Allah isn't just the king. Allah is the owner of kings. Allah is the King of kings. There are many that can call themselves kings, but no one can say that He is the King of kings and the owner of kings and the owner of kingdoms. That is Allah. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ. Allah is the owner of kings. And what does that give Him? تُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. Al-Aziz can give izzah to whomever he wants. تُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. Who has that authority that he can make entities and beings and humans and angels respected and glorified? No one has that authority. Typically speaking, the more power a dictator has, the more despised he is amongst his people. Even though he might have power, but he will never gain the hearts of the people. And Allah is the one saying, I have that power to make people beloved and respected. تُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. Only Allah has that power to genuinely bring about izzah of the people in the hearts of other people. And izzah here means both physical power and respect, because as we said, izzah means both of them. So the one who believes in Al-Aziz should never be scared. The one who believes in Al-Aziz should always have a sense of integrity and honor. The one who believes in Al-Aziz knows that there is no enemy that is worthy of a challenge, because he has Al-Aziz on his side. Every enemy can become no one if Al-Aziz wishes this. And we believe in Al-Aziz. Of the blessings of this name of Al-Aziz, of the thamara or the effects of this name of Al-Aziz, is that it realizes, the Muslim realizes, that there is no object and entity that is worthy of being fearful of other than Allah. There's nothing that you should be scared of. Nothing other than Allah. And this is a sign of Iman. Allah mentions many times in the Quran, and we quoted a verse a few days ago, that when the Sahaba in the Battle of Ahzab, when the Munafiqun became terrified that all people have gathered, إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ. They were terrified. All of mankind has come to attack you. Aren't you scared? And the Sahaba said, فَزَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. So because they believe in Al-Aziz, they're not scared of anybody, because Al-Aziz is the one who can protect them. We said the name Al-Aziz occurs over 90 times in the Quran, and the most common combination of Al-Aziz, it occurs 90 something times, and of course there are many names that occur as pairs. The most common combination is Al-Azizul 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 Hakim. Al-Azizul Hakim, almost 50 times in the Quran. It is one of the most common combinations, along with Ghafoor Rahim and others. Al-Azizul Hakim. Hakim, we're going to come to in a whole lecture by itself, but here we'll just say Al-Hakim means the one full of infinite wisdom and justice, the one of integrity and wisdom. Why Al-Aziz and Al-Hakim? Because generally speaking, in our societies, human beings, power corrupts the intellect. This is the general rule. Power corrupts the intellect. Generally speaking, the philosophers and the thinkers and the mental, if you like, experts are not in politics. And if they go into politics, they forget being wise and whatnot. And our politicians typically lack wisdom. This is the general rule. Because they don't act wisely. Their power corrupts them. Their power makes them act in foolish manners. And you wonder, you were so intelligent before getting elected to office, now all of a sudden, what happened to you? Right? What happens is, power corrupts the soul. This is the general rule. إِنَّ الْمُلُوكَ إِذَا دَخَلُوا قَرْيَةً أَفْسَدُوهَا وَجَعَلُوا عَزَّةَ أَهْلِهَا أَدِلَّا وَكَذَلِكَ يَفْعَلُونَ. Allah mentions in the Quran that the kings, when they enter a village, they destroy everything and they turn everything upside down. And that's how kings do. Kings don't act wisely. Generally speaking, it is very rare to meet a wise politician. You will meet a lot of wise people in many places, in academia, in humanities, in philosophy departments, in alhamdulillah amongst the ulama, many wise people. But amongst the politicians, generally speaking, it's all about nafsi nafsi. It's all about my kursi, my chair, my power. And they forget to act wisely. Allah is saying, I am the one whose power has reached an infinite amount, and that has not corrupted my infinite wisdom. And my wisdom is not coming from weakness. My power does not corrupt my wisdom. And my wisdom is coming from strength, not weakness. So Allah is both Aziz and Hakim. And this is why it's one of the most common combinations in the Quran. Of the most other common combinations is Al-Aziz al-Rahim. It occurs 13 times, Al-Aziz al-Rahim. And Al-Aziz al-Rahim, again, because typically when you gain power, you become hard-hearted. When you gain power, you're no longer sympathetic to the poor. You're no longer caring about the weakest of the weak. You care about the rich and the elite. And this is again the reality across the board, across humanity. It's not just a non-Muslim or Muslim problem. It's the reality. When you mix with the filthy and the rich and the that tabaqa of society, your heart starts becoming attracted to them. And you don't care about the weak and the poor and the masakin and the fuqara. But Allah says, I am Al-Aziz and I am Al-Rahim. My rahmah is coming from strength. My strength has not corrupted my rahmah. So Al-Aziz and Al-Rahim. And there are many other combinations. We don't have time to go into all 92 instances. But very quickly, Al-Aziz Al-Ghafoor and Al-Aziz Al-Ghaffar are also in the Quran. And again, we talked about Ghafoor and Ghaffar. And the fact that Allah forgives even though He is the most powerful. And I mentioned, most of us forgive when we are weak. Most of us, we find it easier to forgive when we are weak. But Allah is saying, I am the one full of power and I still forgive. Al-Aziz al-Ghafoor and Al-Aziz al-Ghaffar. And once in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions it by itself, and that is in Surah Al-Hashr, when Allah has a long list of names, and He says Al-Aziz in that long list of names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, Allah describes Himself as Rabbul Izzah, the Lord of Izzah. So Allah azza wa jalla says that وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ, that all Izzah belongs to Him and to His Messenger, walil mu'mineen. So Allah is the Rabbul Izzah, and His Rasul is the Rasul of Izzah, and He has conferred Izzah on His believers. Walillahi al-izzatu walirasulihi walil mu'mineen. And a few days ago I mentioned that we should be proud to be Muslim, a halal pride. That this is the pride of Allah having guided me. This verse indicates that a Muslim is also azizun nafs. He has a dignity of himself. He has that sense of, Alhamdulillah, I'm a Muslim. And Allah mentions, وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Believers have izzah as well. Because Allah is Al-Aziz. So those who believe in Al-Aziz also have that sense of izzah. And so Allah calls Himself Al-Aziz. And He describes the Prophet as Aziz. And He says, I've conferred izzah on the believers. And He also calls His book Aziz as well. وَإِنَّهُ لَكِتَابٌ عَزِيزٌ. This is an Aziz book, because the book is powerful. Because the book is a source of protection. You turn to the book for physical and spiritual protection. Protection of the heart, protection of the mind, and yes, even protection of the body. When you are physically in harm, you may recite Ayatul Kursi. You may recite Surah Yasin. You may recite verses of the Quran to physically protect you. So even the book is Aziz. So our Lord is a Lord of Izzah. And He sent us a Prophet who is also Aziz. قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَءُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. Our Prophet is Aziz. Our book is Aziz. So therefore we as an ummah as well have to have that sense of izzah. And we call upon Al-Aziz especially when we need the majesty and the power of Allah. Especially when we invoke against our enemies. Especially when we call Allah for protection. يَا قَوِيُّ يَا عَزِيز. And we also can add يَا جَبَّار. We're coming to Jabbar in a few days. All of these are names of Allah that indicate His power, His majesty. May Al-Aziz, the Rabbul Izzah, confer upon us His Izzah. May He grant upon us the Izzah of this dunya and the Akhirah. May Al-Aziz protect us from all the problems of this world and the next. May Al-Aziz gift us with the power and the blessing of having the Izzah, of having the love of the believers in this world and the Malaika in this world and the next. Wa akhiru da'wan alhamdulillah bil alameen. And we'll continue tomorrow. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.